The race to building cutting-edge fighter jets continues with a vengeance. The world was shocked when last fall, U.S. Air Force revealed it had designed, built, and tested a mysterious new fighter jet in the span of just 1 year to replace the leading F-22 and F-35. Beyond admitting the plane exists and uses F-1-style engineering, the Air Force has just dropped its most concrete clues about intriguing technologies to effectively kill Russian and Chinese competitors. We all have seen the flight demonstrator published in Instagram stories for the Air Force's 73rd birthday featuring an unknown new aircraft. Remarkably, the US Air Force continues to allude to the NGAD, but now on a totally new scale. A recent Air Force report includes a description of the NGAD with interesting new concept artwork that shows another futuristic shape for the next generation aircraft. Maybe releasing artworks is part of a deception operation, or maybe gradually teasing an existing type. Whatever, let's firstly cover the latest trends before going deep into the fighter's features. Engineers at Raytheon Intelligence and Space, who developed the brains for NGAD, predicted three future trends for America's new generation fighter program, which will make it superior to existing fifth generation F-22 and F-35. Number 1. Unified System. Sixth generation fighters could have an adaptable Envoy software solution that is a real breakthrough for weapons integration. Fighters no longer have a radar or electronic warfare separately. Instead, multifunction hardware will do it all, like a large transmitter that acts as an air-to-air radar, air-to-ground radar, radio, and electronic warfare platform. The software has already been demonstrated on F-16 and F-18, enabling communication between legacy interfaces and new UAI-type weapons in nanoseconds. Number 2. Flying Data Centers. Next-generation air dominance involves ensuring that everything can share data with everything else, across services and across domains, including air, land, sea, space, and cyberspace. Onboard computer clusters composed of high-performance processors will effectively put a data center in the sky. This aircraft system will leverage massive amounts of computing power to collect and process 10,000 times the data of existing radar systems, equivalent to the internet traffic of a large city every second. For what reason? To create networked combat with war platforms operating as nodes in a larger warfare system of weapons and sensors working together in real time. It is called a family of capabilities. When fighters, bombers, drones, and even land and marine weapons will act via a single strategy to defeat incoming attacks. Number 3. Artificial Intelligence. Today, a flight lead can command 4 or 8 other manned aircraft. Still, the rapid advancement of unmanned aircraft technologies and AI could make feasible production of an autonomous robotic fighter or remotely piloted aircraft with an off-board crew. The pilot and AI have already successfully teamed to share the sensor and achieve the mission objectives of operating the U-2 spy plane in a historic first. And it's only the beginning. The next planned step is a sixth-generation fighter that could land autonomously, without human control, or provide guidance to pilots landing under challenging circumstances, like landing in aircraft carriers or in rough weather at a precise landing zone. A cockpit-bound AI could oversee the jamming of enemy radars and monitor for threats to the plane, like incoming missiles, and then automatically launch chaff or flares to lure the missile away. However, these key trends would be essential for all countries, manufacturers of sixth-generation fighter jets, including Russia with the MiG-41, Europe with the Tempest, or China with the J-20. What's more interesting, that America has envisioned specific superiority technologies to defeat all of them. A new Congressional Research Service report on NGAD gives a quick rundown of the program. The secret new fighter jet is just a part of a program that will likely include crewed and uncrewed aircraft, electronic warfare and cyber warfare, new weapons, and other systems. The aircraft is expected to be large, diamond-shaped with large engine air intakes over the airplane's wing, trailing to the left and right of the cockpit, where the inputs would be shielded from radar from below. The aircraft also features two engines, a bubble canopy cockpit, and two vertical stabilizers that can be retracted to fold flat into the wings. So to kill all enemy fighters, American 6th-gen fighters must be lethal and able to shoot down enemy aircraft, particularly at long range. Despite failing its recent tests, Boeing's X-51A Waverider scramjet is expected to reach hypersonic speeds of Mach 6, a speed at which a missile cannot be stopped by conventional air defense technology. Also, the Air Force is reportedly developing a new long-range air-to-air missile, the AIM-260, to equip the F-35 and other jets. The AIM-260 is designed to outstick Russian and Chinese fighters, like the Sukhoi Su-57 Felon and Chengdu J-20, shooting them down before their American opponents come within range of their own missiles. Another possibility is an air-to-air laser capable of shooting down enemy fighters and incoming missiles. So-called directed energy weapons are high-powered microwaves and lasers to shoot down incoming missiles in seconds or even attacking small targets on the ground with pinpoint precision. A laser, powered by the fighter jet's engines, could theoretically fire unlimited shots in an engagement. To compare, the leading F-35 Joint Strike Fighter's GAU-12 25mm gun holds only 200 rounds. The NGAD fighter wouldn't work alone. In the concept art, two vertical lines emanate from the aircraft's nose and are aimed upward, indicating connections to satellite and airborne communication nodes. That would allow the NGAD pilot to jack into a stream of data from nearby friendly forces, from Air Force early warning unmanned aircraft to Navy destroyers, and obtain a picture of the battlefield without turning on his or her own radar and other systems. That's the multi-domain awareness to which the Air Force refers. Modern combat aircraft receives new weapons all the time, but refitting an existing aircraft with new engines capable of power lasers could be too complicated. Moreover, the fighter jet is expected to fly longer and farther than current fighters. The blended body and wing configuration would yield a large internal volume that could store fuel and weapons in internal weapons bays. The Air Force reportedly wants a fighter with the range to accompany bombers into deep penetration missions over the Asia-Pacific, Eastern Europe, or even Eastern Russia. The Air Force could increase persistence through more fuel-efficient propulsion. Variable cycle engines with a third airstream could be a solution to increase range, speed, and efficiency. By opening or closing the third airstream, the pilot can adjust the fuel intake of the jet engine and optimize its performance. With the higher temperature combustion, a new thermal management system will use the turbine as a heat sink to recycle thermal energy. It will remove the need for overboard venting and increase electrical power production. This extra energy will be used to power all the aircraft's subsystems or future lasers. With such speed and weapons, the Air Force's secret new fighter jet must avoid being detected on the modern aerial battlefield. One obvious suggestion is the new, next-generation anti-radar stealth build in the skin of the aircraft. Many of today's fighters use a nose or pod-mounted infrared sensor to detect enemy aircraft. An aircraft warmer than the surrounding air becomes detectable to such an infrared sensor, especially the hot gases blowing out of the rear of the plane. Infrared stealth would be very useful against weapons like the Russian R-73 infrared guided missile. Materials and microelectronics technologies in skin stealth would turn the aircraft into a large integrated sensor, possibly eliminating the need for a nose radar. Advanced skins manage a plane's heat distribution to foil radar, infrared, and thermal detection systems to become low observable. These skins can heat up or cool down all parts of an aircraft's surface to perfectly match the surrounding atmosphere, making it virtually undetectable. Although most of America's stealth fighters plan to open fire before the enemy is in visual range, if the air battle devolves into a swirling dogfight, optical stealth would be very useful. Indeed, with all of the features, the US NGAD is the most expensive program of the sixth generation fighter jets. NGAD has examined more than 650 different ideas for sixth-gen combat, which were then narrowed down to merely a few. The House Armed Services Committee reported spendings of $1 billion only in fiscal 2020, with guesstimates around a total of $20 billion for research and development. To reduce costs and shorten the development time of new aircraft, the Air Force uses digital engineering technology, which involves using virtual modeling and simulation tools. Sixth-gen fighters are expected to utilize modular designs to some degree, meaning the aircraft itself will be designed to allow for components to be removed and easily replaced with better ones. This will not only increase the lifespan of each aircraft, it will allow for rapid deployment of more advanced sensors avionics, and weapon systems than ever before. What other bells and whistles will define the fighters of the future? Hope we'll find out soon enough. And that's all the time we have for today's video. Please give this video a like if you learned something new, and make sure you subscribe so you never miss another video from Front Cost. See you next time.